Hey, Wes here. Sometimes you'll need to remove the Kodrone EDU's propellers to clear out debris, like hair or thread from clothing, or just to reattach the propeller from a crash. Other times, the propeller may need to be replaced. While the Kodrone EDU is durable, it's also not indestructible. After many crashes, or after a very severe crash, you may end up with damaged propellers. If your propellers have large enough scratches or have chipped off enough to affect flight stability, it might be time to replace it with a new propeller. Inside your Kodrone EDU box, you'll find four propellers. Before we get started, let's talk about the importance of propeller placement. With the drone facing this way, the red propellers are at the front of the drone, and the black propellers are in the back of the drone. The colors are an easy way to identify the direction the drone is facing when it's flying. The propellers on the drone spin in one of two directions, clockwise and counterclockwise. These are the directions that the propellers will spin when the drone flies. An easy way to remember which way each propeller should spin is to think of them as always spinning towards the middle. So in the front of the drone, these two propellers spin towards the nose, and in the back of the drone, these two propellers spin towards the tail. If you look at a clockwise versus a counterclockwise propeller from the side, you'll notice a difference in the way the propellers are sloped. But an easier way to tell the direction of the propeller is by the small letter underneath the propeller. F is for clockwise, R is for counterclockwise. One easy way to remember is F is for fast forward, so it rotates clockwise when viewing from above. R is for rewind, so it turns counterclockwise when viewing from above. And here it is, all together. To remove the propellers, you can either use the removal tool included in the box, which looks like this, or you can do it by hand. To remove it with the tool, you'll want to slide the curved fork side of the tool underneath the center of the propeller, and then use it like a lever to push the propeller off of the shaft of the motor. To remove it by hand, you can grab both sides of the propeller as close to the middle as possible, and grab hold of the middle of the propeller with your thumb. Then hold the motor with your other hand. Once you have a firm grip, pull up. The propellers are friction fitted, so you may need to pull firmly at first. The blades of the propellers are pretty bendable, but make sure not to grab the propellers too far out from the middle if you're removing propellers that you intend to still use. Propellers that get bent too many times can warp. It's also just easier to remove the propeller if you pull closer to the middle. Now that the damaged propeller is removed, make sure you're replacing it with the correct replacement propeller. Check that the color and the letter on the bottom are the same. If you need to use a different color propeller, that's also okay, just make sure that the letter matches. Remember, F is for clockwise, R is for counterclockwise. To place the propeller, just line up the hub of the propeller with the shaft of the motor, then push downward. Make sure not to push so hard that the propeller doesn't spin. You can check that the propeller is placed properly by giving it a light flick. As long as it rotates, it should be placed correctly. It doesn't necessarily need to spin freely, it just shouldn't feel like there's immediate resistance when you test the rotation. It's a good idea to also give your Kodrone EDU a test flight just to make sure it's flying properly. Do a takeoff, check the hovering, and fly it around a little bit to check for drift. If needed, you may need to readjust the propeller a few more times and also do some trimming, which is covered in another video. With a fresh new propeller, hopefully you're back in the air in no time. Happy flying out there.